Welcome to this tutorial in how to translate darktable and how to re-enable the language that maybe disappeared when darktable was updated last time. So my main language is Swedish, and I have re-enabled it from in 3.8, but as you can see here, for example, Russian is gone. But you had that in 3.6, but not in 3.8. So I will show you how to re-enable and how to translate some parts. First of all, you will need Poedit. So download and install it. And after that, you will need this folder. And you can go here to GitHub and Darktable and press code and download the zip file. And then you unzip it in your folder. And here you have the folder. And here you have the files. And as you can see here, you do have a lot more languages than you had in, let's check inside here. So we don't have Russian inside here, but we still have it here. Anyway, my main language is Swedish, so I will open this file, Swedish, and I will open it with Poedit. So this is how it looks. You have English on the left side and Swedish on the right side, or your language, of course. And some parts are missing. First of all, you will need to update from POT file, and you will find that in the same folder, and the name is darktable.pot, so just open it up and update it. And then you will see down here how much is translated, and so in my case I do have 2,800 translations of 4,000 something. Anyway, if I want to translate something, I check, let's close this one. So this one is still in English, modals. So I want to translate that one. Then I go back to Poedit. I use the search feature. That is already translated. That one is not, okay? Modular. Now I have translated it to Swedish. And I save. And to be able to use this in Darktable, I need to export it as a MO file. And the name of this will be darktable.mo. And it doesn't matter where you save it, just save it somewhere. And now I close the window here. And I close Darktable. Okay, let's check. There it is. And I need to put it in the right place, so I open a terminal. There, I do have perfect command. Okay, so I will copy it from Darktable, from this folder, and I will copy darktable.mo, and I will put it in user share local, Swedish, and LC message. Write my password, and now it copied in to the right folder. I open Darktable again. And there it is, translated. Perfect. Okay, how to do this in Windows? So I have already prepared it. Let's check Windows. So in this case, I don't have my language at all here. Only Deutsch, English, yeah, anything. So I close Windows. And I do have my .mo file, darktable.mo, here. And I need to put it in the right place in Windows. And let's see. And it is in local disk, program files, darktable, share. And local. And I need to find my folder for Swedish. Here it is. And inside there too. And just put it here. And then I open Darktable again. And it will be a little bit slow because it's a virtual box. So it's not a real Windows machine. Okay, settings, general, and Swedish. And Darktable needs to be restarted, okay. Yeah, that will take a while. Okay, Swedish, perfect. Thank you very much for watching this video.